Keeps challenging me with this thing, so I'm asking him to give me understanding how to walk every day in limitless grace. Because he spoke to me this week, he said, you know, all these things you're going through are necessary. I told you you have limitless grace. I said, okay, then I need to understand how to tap into it.
Amen. Thank
you, Lord. So then that there's nothing that comes along I am not prepared for.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Because it's one thing to know that you have something. It's another to know how to access it.
Amen.
Romans 5 says that we have access by faith into this grace.
Amen.
So we know that no matter what God has promised us, the number one way to access it is by faith. You have to believe God for it. You have to talk like it.
Amen.
You have to confess that you have it.
Amen.
Amen. So the reason I'll keep bringing it to you so that you can remember it when life hits you, because when life hits, many times we forget.
Amen.
You don't even remember any scripture.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It's even more important to speak about limitless grace now, after we also sowed a seed for Eagle 2. Because as I will show you, you will not find any other context in the Bible, in the scriptures, where limitless grace is abundantly mentioned, except through this mystery of giving to God. I'll say it again. You will not find any other context in this Bible where abundance of grace, the mechanics of it, how it is released, how it comes, you won't find any other context except this mystery and ministry of exercising your faith through seed. This thing that God said to me, so you know, you don't have to be going through all of this. You have limitless grace. I said, this is the second time. Years ago, when I was contending for what we are now living in, that's the same thing he said to me. Now we are contending for what is to come.
Amen.
The battles are all the same.
Amen.
They're fierce. They're challenging. They're difficult. But again, the counsel of the Lord. Now, the first time he said to me, you are like a man in an ocean, and you have soap in your eyes, and you cannot get it off. You have all the water. It's the same thing. All right. So, let's read 2 Corinthians 9, verse 6. But this I say, he which soweth sparingly shall reap also
sparingly.
Immediately you see that the way you receive in this kingdom is based on how you sow. However, the natural man says the way you get ahead is to hold what you have. Then you will limit yourself to what you can do.
Amen.
Supernatural doors will not open to you. Miracles will not happen in your life. God will not connect you with relationships that will help you go forward. What I'm describing are avenues of supernatural inferences in your life. He says, if you sow sparingly, you will also reap
sparingly.
All right. However, no matter how much you sow, you must believe God.
Amen.
This is important. I don't want you to sow seed and believe that it's magic. Everything must be accompanied
Amen.
With the commensurate level of faith
Amen.
To drive it.
Yeah.
The act of sowing the seed is faith. But after you sow it, you must believe
Amen.
That what God said will happen. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. That's what he was just saying to us earlier. It don't matter what Satan is saying. It don't matter what evidence he's showing to you. Ignore him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What God said will stand.
Amen.
If I didn't ignore Satan, I would have gone crazy. Through all those years. And up till tomorrow, I don't know why he doesn't give up. He continues to talk. Hoping that you will listen. I'm not giving him a compliment. So Lord, fix whatever I'm saying now. So now watch. I actually was impressed by the tenacity of these demons. I learned from them never to give up. Because it doesn't matter how many times you beat them, they keep. So I said, hey, wait a minute. Me too can do the same thing. I just keep saying what God said. I just keep praising God. I just keep praying in the Holy Ghost. It doesn't matter what happens. I just keep doing the same thing. You don't give up. Hey, you haven't seen not giving up. Because my not giving up is backed up by the Holy Ghost. It's backed up by God and his power. But watch, believers are always parking some corner and start powering. How can Satan be more diligent than you? Now, you ought to tell him, hey, you think you got something? I got something to show you. I am just getting started. I am not saying these things to get a rise out of you. I'm telling you, that's what I did. Because when I kept fasting and praying, I wasn't seeing anything, and the devil came mocking me. I told him, you haven't seen anything yet because I'm not through fasting. I'm just getting started.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I said, I'm about to go on longer ones. I said, I'm going to keep fasting until you drop off. And guess what? One day he dropped off.
Amen.
Hallelujah. He couldn't hold on. I don't want to talk about the roller coasters that the thing messes up because those are dangerous. But haven't you seen sometimes when you hold on to something, then after a while your hand starts getting tired and then you drop off. Hallelujah. That's how you wear the enemy out. Why? He's not patient. All he does is to continue to come back. But I am patient. So, I'm going to win.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So, you have to understand these things because when you sow your seed, the enemy will begin a campaign of unbelief. Trying to talk you out of your faith.
Amen.
Don't listen to him.
Amen.
I remember when I sowed my largest seed, I don't know, it was last year. And all of a sudden, he came to me. He said, don't you see? Nothing has happened. You're blessed, but you didn't get the commensurate response from
Amen.
God.
Amen.
All these things you thought would have happened hasn't happened.
Amen.
I said, come here. How do you know what God has for me? He couldn't answer me. I said, okay, when you find the answer, we can resume the conversation. I said, because you cannot look at me and decide what God has for me.
Amen.
You can't look at what is happening now and decide what God has already planned. Amen. From the foundation of the world. Oh, hallelujah. I'm about to preach myself happy. I feel him washing over me. Do you know what the Holy Ghost just said to me? He said, when you sow a seed unto me, you're not just sowing a seed for what is happening now. He said, you're sowing a seed to unlock what I did from the foundation. Hey, is somebody here? He said, these works were finished before you were born. You're trying to tap into a finished work. He said, the only reason Satan is talking to you, he said, you don't have a mindset of the finished work. Amen. You are looking at what is to happen. No, you are sowing into something to receive what's already done. Yeah. Is somebody understanding what I'm saying? Watch, watch. Because he's speaking to me as I'm talking to you. He said, Jesus said, I give you keys. Not to the kingdom, but of the kingdom. Do you understand the difference? If I had to say, I give you keys to this church, that means you get a key to come in the door. But I'm already in the kingdom. So I don't need the keys to the kingdom. The key to the kingdom is Jesus. But he says, but after you've come in, I will give you keys of the kingdom. So you can go to different doors and start opening doors to go into what? Hey, you open a door and you see things with your name on it and you start grabbing. You grab. You grab. What's yours? Amen. I was speaking to a friend, you know. He ministers some things to some members of the church, and I was confused. I said, what has gone wrong? And I said to him, I have never coveted anything you have. And if there's anything you have that I need, I will ask you. Why would you come into my house and start ministering something behind my back? Amen. I said, that's a breach of covenant. Amen. I said, that says you don't know what belongs to you. Amen. Because everything I have, I got it from no one. Amen. You see? I don't know why your amen is weak. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? I don't chase after anything. I don't covet what anybody has. That's for them. Amen. But my stuff works for me. Amen. It is sufficient for me. Amen. You have to understand it. He said, I'll give you keys of the kingdom. Why? I'm already in the house. And then he teaches me principles to unlock what belongs to me. Amen. That's why he taught me seed sowing.
Amen.
And there's so many principles that God will teach you so you can get into what is already yours. I say it again. Because these things are happening while I'm speaking to you. He said this is the shift that must happen in all of us, whether you're watching from home or you're sitting in the sanctuary. Your faith must shift in from what God is going to do into tapping into what God has already done. Amen. Faith in the finished work. Amen. What I'm believing for is what has already been done. Amen. And faith unlocks that door. Amen. And I get the lesser keys to open the door. Amen. Well, you live in America all your life, but you don't understand. If you go overseas, you see that the door outside has the biggest lock than the door inside. Actually, now in Nigeria, when you build a house, you put bulletproof doors in the front. All the outside doors are bulletproof. And then you put one to your bedroom. in case they get past all of that thing. So, but all the other doors are wood and stuff, you know, minor things. So faith is the key to enter the house. Amen. But then these other smaller keys are to unlock what God has already done. Amen. He says, so when you are sowing seeds, you are sowing seed to tap into what God has already given to you. Amen. That has your name on it. That emboldens your faith. Okay. I was saying that emboldens your faith. He said, not only that, that increases the intensity of your expectation and thanksgiving. Amen. So I walk around thanking God. Thank you, Lord, that my blessing is coming forth. I have released my seed by faith. Grace is coming to me. Miracles are coming to me. Hallelujah. My seed will never fall to the ground and die. I'm preaching Bible to you. He said, if I'm a tither, God will rebuke the devourer. And years ago, he said to me, you rebuke things when you see it. But I rebuke things before you know they exist. So, when you understand that, you know that it doesn't matter where you are or what state you are, where your finances are, or what's going on. The only way to move from that location to the next level in this kingdom is through seed. Amen. Amen. He said, if you sow sparingly, you will reap. Uh-huh. So, you don't want to wonder what the future holds. Remember now, the blessing is already yours. It has your name on it. Amen. We're talking about how to access it or get it to come to you. So, if you don't like where you are, then start listening to God and keep sowing seeds. He said, not every now and then. You sow continuously. That's what I was telling the enemy. Well, first of all, who invited you to the conversation? Amen. I didn't ask for counseling. Amen. Why are you interested in my seed? It is God that I gave my seed to. Yeah. I said, you wait. He showed me dreams of what Resurrection House is going to be here in a minute. Amen. I said, haven't I modeled it for you? Haven't I taught you these things, testified of them, and you see them happening. I said, when you look at resurrection, it looks like he's not going. Then you wake up one day, he's gone. Not he's going, he's gone. Amen. We don't count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. No, we stay on one. And we are praising God. And we are shouting. And we are sowing our seed. And we are making noise. And after a while, even the enemy is confused. Why is my stuff not working? This is resurrection. We are on a blast pad. This is a rocket about to take off. This is a supernatural life. And as soon as the button is pressed, 10. Think about it. I was shaving. And here comes the unction. God said, now, so $2,000 a month to Kenneth Copeland Ministries. Market aviation and increase. And do it for 1 year. I was so excited, I started immediately.
Amen.
Because it was in November. So I sold December. And got into January. And sold the whole year. Mm-hmm. A regular pastor who cannot hear from God will say, man, give another ministry $2,000 a month? My God, you say, that's $24,000. Isn't that how the natural man thinks? Then he would have kept his $24,000. He can't get anything done. I immediately started sending my money. And all of a sudden, I wish you knew another language besides English. They say in Igbo, he said, "Aneji pererem, morufe." In other words, you see how the bird flutters the wing? They say that's pererem. Don't you see how it sounds? It's so sweet, you know. He said, that's how you learn to fly. Now watch. I just obeyed God and sowed my seed. I came to church and did services like I'm doing right now. I didn't know how he would come back. I'll show it to you in this series. Because he said that's the way the kingdom works. I didn't know how it would work. I didn't know. I wasn't seeing any massive increase in membership or all these things. And without any fundraising, without saying anything to anyone, without being able to explain myself, the income of the church grew $1 million. I don't know why you're not shouting. Wait now. It wasn't just that he grew $1 million, but he grew $1 million in the COVID year of 2020. When God said, don't shut my house down. Listen, I'm recommending a movie. I've told the leaders to come see it with me this evening. It's called Super Spreader, where this guy stood his ground in California when the governor said that even if you have church, you can't sing. He stood up against him, hallelujah. The same way I stood up against them. And all the warfare and all the things that happened. And the same people are telling me that they want to do a movie on Glory Fall USA. Is this our greatest year or what? Beloved, this ministry is fueling a new revolution in my faith. And I'm believing, God, that the same grace will come to you. You don't know how much your faith struggles because you're believing God for what you think he hasn't done, and you're believing him to do it. No. That's why you've struggled. That's why your faith is off track. No, we're believing God to receive what he has already done. I'm blessed. I am healed. I am delivered. Jesus paid for it all. Even the book of Hebrews, I believe, makes it even worse. It says, the works we have finished from the foundation of the world. On the cross, Jesus says, it is finished. I'm telling you, power will be released in your faith. Rest will come to you. You know it's only a matter of time. You start thanking God for the things you believe because you know he has already done it. It's so massive. I don't know how to get it across to you. It's so massive because all those satanic inlets into your life would disappear. Satan cannot come and tell you now, God doesn't love you. He hasn't done this. He did this for somebody else, but he didn't do it for you. It's already done. You shut Satan down. You shut his accusations against God down. You shut his lies and discouragements down in your life. Faith in the finished work. What we need, as you'll discover in the message, is the wisdom of God. That's why the book of Proverbs says wisdom is the principal thing. Where do you hear these things I'm teaching you?
It's the principal thing, because you need it to understand your next steps. I am already in the kingdom. Jesus says, I give you keys of the kingdom. Watch. If it was keys to the kingdom, that's how you come in the kingdom. But I'm already in the kingdom. So he gives me keys for the kingdom, the doors, to unlock it, to enter into what he has for me. That's what we need wisdom for. You are in the house, but the bedroom is locked. The pantry is locked. Everything you need, the doors are locked. Then he gives you keys to open this door so you can access what already belongs to you. When I was listening to this, it's like the Holy Spirit showed me a picture. You come, one of the things we deal with, let me put it this way, are breaches that are hindering us from the wisdom we need. So you come, you see, unforgiveness. They're telling you what the lock is, unforgiveness. Then you forgive, and now the door opens. Over here, you see bitterness. You release it, the door opens. Over here, lust is, you know, messing with you, and they say lust. You repent of it, the door opens. Keys of the kingdom. He tells you what you need to unlock that door. God bless you. We love you. Awesome. Bye-bye. When dead things come.